Welcome to Inside Lake Forest. I'm Eileen Luby, your host, and today I'm going to be visiting with Smith's Men's Store, located here at 770 Northwestern Avenue, next to the Lantern. They carry everything from traditional formal wear, tuxedo rentals, to casual wear. Let's step inside and see what they're all about.
Hi.
Hi, John. How are you?
Good, Eileen. How are you? Nice to see you.
Great. John Tadell, who is owner of Smith's Men's Store.
I am.
John, tell me about the history of Smith's Men's Store.
Well, Smith's goes back a long way. It was started in 1937 by Walter Smith. The strange story about that is that he was going to open a business with George Robertson, but he was a little short on funds. So George opened the business, which was Robertson's. People remember was at the location where Blockbuster did. And it was about 10 years later when Walter got his business going to Market Square.
Okay.
Then in the early 60s, he moved the store to 662 Western. And then in 1988, we opened up here at 770.
Great. Now, John, when did you step into the picture of the history of Smith's?
It was 1972. I just graduated from college, and I was waiting to get drafted. And I walked in to talk to Brooks Smith about sponsoring a softball team. And he said, no, I won't sponsor your softball team, but what are you doing this summer? I said, I'm waiting to get my notice. He said, well, would you like to put in some time while you're waiting? And I've been here ever since.
Great, so you really got locked in once he opened the doors.
I did. One thing led to another, and it escalated to the point where I ended up buying the store in 1988.
So it's been you and the store since 1988. You've had a long history, and the store has had a long history. And the great thing about it is you all have been Lake Forest residents from day one. It's truly been a hometown store that's been able to provide wonderful men's clothing to our residents for
definitely,
so many years.
Definitely. The Smith's roots can be traced all the way back to the 1830s here, as can the Yore roots.
Wow.
So, you know, it's a lot of tradition here.
So, John, I'd love to hear more about what the store offers today, from the traditional clothes that have really started back when the store opened to what you're carrying now.
Okay. Well, our philosophy has always been, you know, button-down Oxford cloth shirt, blue blazer, gray slacks. We're still firm believers in that tradition. However, as a sign of the times, with nobody dressing up as much as they used to, we've really gone a lot into more weekend wear, casual wear, business casual wear. So we do a lot of slacks, a lot of sports shirts, sweaters. That's become the backbone of the business now.
Okay. And I think, too, probably your lines shift a little bit, too, with seasonality, of course. So
now you've got,
I see in your store here, like, a lot of great polos, solids and stripes, and the Madras shorts.
Yep, we're getting into the bright season.
So John, in terms of, I mean, you have really been such a big part of kind of watching the men's clothing era evolve over the years. What would you say, talking a little bit more about specific traditional kind of Lake Forest wear, and then maybe tell me a little bit about what's the best sellers now?
Well, strangely enough, like the old saying, what comes around goes around. Madras is big right now. Seersucker things are big right now. Things that were big 30 years ago seem to be popular again, especially with a lot of the young kids, which is kind of fun to see. See kids wearing these wild shorts and tops and stuff, so that's kind of neat stuff. We've always kind of tried to keep that, what we call a traditional look, and especially for this particular area, the whole North Shore, I suppose, if you want to put it that way.
Sure. Well, I'm sure, of course, that you draw from not only Lake Forest area, but from some of the other surrounding communities as well.
Well, definitely Lake Forest and Lake Bluff are what keeps us rolling, and we appreciate all that support. But more so, we're getting our kind of customer coming from other towns because they've seen their local stores close.
Okay.
So we're getting a little business from that.
Well, and I think that's really important too, because, you know, supporting local businesses is really the key and the heart of any community, in that, you know, the tax dollars that are spent here Absolutely. Are then utilized in our school systems and, you Absolutely. Know, real estate values.
A lot of people don't realize, you know, one of the reasons they move to a community like this is because it's quaint, it's got a nice shopping district, the central business district is pretty, it's beautiful. But they need to support the businesses to keep that going. And the businesses, all the businesses I know, have always given back to the community as well.
Absolutely.
So it's a good symbiotic relationship, or should be a good
relationship. And I know you're a member of the Chamber of Commerce and have always been a big supporter of community involvement as well. And I think too, John, I'd like to take a little tour on the store so we can kind of highlight some of the more particular items that you have here so people can come in and shop.
Okay.
Great.
Casual wear has become a big deal.
Yeah, you've got some great sport, you know, both socks and
Yeah, we like to fool around with some of the Cubs and Sox stuff, and we get into the Bears things in the fall.
Mm-hmm. And then you've got here, I know, like a lot of great golf shirts.
Right, a couple lines that we carry that have really been popular, Cutter and Buck and Peter Millar.
Mm-hmm.
They've been excellent. And it's nice stuff, just fun to wear.
Mm-hmm.
Some of it's what I say, some are for playing golf in and some are for just looking good after golf.
That's great. And how about, I mean, you really carry everything from socks to boxer shorts.
Yeah, we're the nuts and bolts for most guys.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can do it all. We got clothing, we do sport coats, suits.
Let's take a walk to the back of the store, John.
Okay.
And tell me a little bit more about the opportunities for customers to come in and have things tailored.
Well, that's a really good point, because we can have things tailored. We have the ability to adjust the waist, do an exact length. You know, we don't just sell a size 36, 32.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not everybody's built like that either. Some people are 30 and a half inches in the inseam, so we do definitely have the ability to do that. We can fine-tune a garment or a trouser to their specifications, so that's another thing that we offer.
So, John, what I think is just really fun here are all of the different types of casual pants that you carry. Everything, like we talked, some of the hot items, like Seersucker, the Madras. You've got these great, like, multicolored, you know, from the Vineyard Vines collection.
Yeah, panel pants.
Panel pants. I mean, just so fun. And now, tell me, can these be also be custom altered as well?
Absolutely. And that's why we buy them unfinished, so that we can make that length to the exact length of the customer. All these trousers are built with a waistband that can be taken in or let out easily and will show no marks. And so you get a much, much better fit than you would with something just off the rack.
That's great. I mean, it's so fun, John, that you carry such the traditional look as you're wearing. To something more kind of country club casual or just really fun summer wear.
And we do, I mean, you know, we do everything from the basic trousers, sell a ton of khaki pants for both work and play, and the weekend kind of thing, and the cocktail party thing. Some of the other things that we do some semi-custom and custom work.
Okay.
And I'd love to show you a jacket that we did for On Wednesday Club.
Oh, great.
And this was a jacket that we had made.
Oh, how fun.
And it's trimmed out in the old colors for when they used to do hunts.
And with the buttons, too, even.
Absolutely.
Everything finished down to the T.
Yep.
Wonderful. So, John, you also do so custom suits and jackets.
Yes, we
and
do.
And people can pick fabric.
Yeah,
and
we've got tons of different fabrics.
Okay.
So a gentleman could come in and say, I'd like to have this kind of a suit.
Mm-hmm.
And we can have it made for them. That's not
That's
a problem at all.
That's really great. I'm just really enjoying coming in, and I'm thinking about my father and my brothers and sending them in to get their new spring and summer looks.
I remember when your grandfather used to come in, as a matter of fact.
Yes, and all of his great sweaters that he was wearing in his later years.
It was always a pleasure to have him in.
Thank you. Well, John, too, let's talk also about not just the necessities, the jackets, the pants, slacks, But also, you have a lot of accessory items too for men. Of course, ties, which are a should be a staple in any well-dressed man's closet.
Absolutely, and of course, we do all the basic things, the things everybody needs: the underwear, socks, all that kind of stuff. Basic dress shirts.
Okay.
And again, dress shirts is another thing. We've got millions of options there.
Okay, so people can have dress shirts custom made. Oh,
and
great.
Many, many companies and choices to choose from.
Mm-hmm. The tie selection, John, tell me a little bit about the history in the types of ties. I know, kind of watching my dad clean out his closet every once in a while, he'd have those, you know, skinny long or the real wide.
Yeah, they seem to, ties is one of those things that seem to follow the lapel width.
Okay.
When lapel widths get wider, the ties get wider. When the lapels get narrower, the ties get narrower. So we're starting to see ties narrow a little bit. It's also a sign of conservative times.
Okay.
So with things the way they are, you'll see things pull back a little bit.
Okay.
And you know, maybe we'll get away from some of the fashion edge items and more into the mainstream things when the economy gets a little.
So it goes really like going back to the roots and the traditions and, you know, talking a lot about like family and history there versus some of the more outlandish styles that can
Well,
be.
We certainly don't chase fashion here. I don't understand that business at all, really. So we try to stay middle of the road and maybe hit a curb on one side or the other once in a while. But we're pretty steady right down the middle of that road.
That's good. Well, and it fits who Lake Forest is.
We think so.
Kate, you're definitely catering to the customer.
We hope.
Now, John, too, I'm just looking here, but all of these Vineyard Vine ties, this has been what I've seen with my brothers and that type of, you know, age group, the high school, college guys, really been a popular item.
It's been a phenomenon.
And I think it's so important for our residents to know that they don't have to shop online to get them. They can come in here and support a local business, and
Absolutely.
The prices are the same,
price
and they
exactly
don't have to pay shipping, and they can come here and pick out. Now, John, can you also order ties if they see something online that
Not
they don't
a problem
have?
At all. I'm probably in contact with most of my companies on a weekly basis.
That's great. Well, I know you've done that for me before, so.
Yeah, it's always a pleasure to do that for somebody.
That's great. Yeah, there's just so many different styles.
Right, can't carry them all.
Exactly.
But can certainly try to get them.
And what great gifts, too, especially with Father's
Perfect.
Day coming up in
Father's
June.
Father's Day, graduation, things like that.
Excellent. So, John, you've pulled a couple of things out to show me. Tell me a little bit about some of the accessories you carry.
Okay, these are some of the, we'll carry different cufflink sets.
Mm-hmm.
French cuff shirts are popular. They're not a huge seller, but you got to have the cufflinks to go with them.
Mm-hmm.
We do a lot of stuff in formal wear, so we carry lots of different stud and cufflink sets. While we're on the formal wear subject, we do some tie and cummerbund sets. This particular one's from Vineyard Vines. It's just festive and fun.
Very fun.
Lobster that they call clam bake.
Now, John, do you teach people how to correctly tie?
It takes a while. You'd be surprised how difficult tying a bow is.
Mm-hmm.
Most men are all thumbs when it comes to it. But, yeah, there's been times when we've had people come in at 5 minutes of closing, desperate. Can you tie my tie for me? And, of course, we do.
Good.
Get them on their way.
If they don't, so especially the young men, it'd be a nice opportunity for them to come in and learn how from you, John.
Absolutely.
You can educate them on proper formal wear attire and how to tie.
Right.
And then you also carry some leather
goods.
Right,
we do some leather goods. We do wallets and money clips and some travel kits. So.
And you've got belts, too. And
we do.
I know
belts,
I did see in the story
both
above.
Both casual and dress.
Dress belts, which is great.
That's obviously a necessity.
Absolutely. So. How about suspenders? Do you see a lot of those?
Not a lot anymore.
Okay.
It's one of those things that comes and goes. We always carry a few. You know, we've always got some basic sets around.
Mm-hmm.
But, it's one of those things that runs hot and cold.
Okay, great. Well, John, it's so important, I think, again, to know that the business, and you have been such longtime residents, and it's so great to see that yourself, as well as several other of the longtime businesses in the community, are still successful and prospering because of the community support that they've given.
Well, and that's the key. It's because of that support that we've all gotten over the years, and a lot of loyal customers, and that's what keeps us here.
John, tell me when customers can come and visit you during the week.
Our normal hours are Monday through Friday, 9:30 to 6, and Saturday, 9 to 5.
Okay.
We're closed on Sundays, except during the December.
Okay, month. So during the holiday month,
right.
So you might have extended hours there.
Exactly.
And so customers can stop in, or they can give you a call, and
you
your
give me a call?
Phone number is?
That's 847-234-5866.
Great. Well, John, it's truly been a pleasure.
Eileen, thanks for stopping by.
Thank you so much. I've really enjoyed learning about all the traditional men's clothing that you have to offer, as well as some of the more fun items as well here.
Well, great. I'm glad you enjoyed your visit.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching Inside Lake Forest. Today, I've been visiting with John Tadell here at Smith's Men's Store, located on Western Avenue. It's been established since 1937. Stop in today and support this local business. Thank you.